A new year, a new Z. What's inside the newest ZBox monthly subscription box? And you know, it seems like it's been a while since we had a look at a ZBox subscription box. Perhaps it's just the trickling of the courier system right now. That's where we're finally now starting to see these boxes popping up again. It could also be the case that I just recently had a look at this and my mind has just escaped me completely. But nonetheless, though, every single month, ZBox will deliver to you a selection of geek items, such as t-shirts, such as trade paperbacks, such as geek collectibles, and so much more. We're going to go ahead and get this opened up and check out the contents. And if you do like the contents contained inside, consider then the idea of subscribing to the ZBox by clicking the link down below in the video description. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get this cut open. Can't help but notice there is a little bit of tape on the front, and that's always a good thing. That has guaranteed to me, at least, that no pirates or vultures have attacked this. Or pirate vultures, that's even worse. But we're going to go ahead and cut the seal on the front of the box. And for that, I'm going to reach off camera and grab my knife, Chet Cunnington III, and make short work of that seal, like a hot knife through butter. Let's see what we got for the contents inside. First thing I want to pull out is a Minico figure, Lord of the Rings Golem. That's pretty cool. I have collected Minico characters in the past, Batman and Pennywise to name a few, and I've never actually seen a Golem. Really like the look of that one. I might actually even just consider the idea of reviewing this guy as a separate video if you guys would like to see that. On the back, though, the Series 1 characters consist of Gandalf, Frodo, and Golem. And I can't tell you if that's the entire series or that's simply just wave one of these figures. But nonetheless, though, that's pretty cool. Really, really happy to get that. Of course, we also have some packing pillows. We don't need those, so I can make short work of those. We'll just throw those to the side. And in case you're curious, yes, in 2021, the black hole has come back. I've offered him up employment. He decided to try his luck as a street artist. And everybody knows you can't be a street artist nowadays. Money gets awfully tight. So he's come back to the fold. Him and producer Tony now working, collaborating together. I'm hoping for big things in 2021. That being said, let's pull out the next thing. We've got ourselves a mini or my emoji Ghostbusters. And it is, I'm just trying to see who it comes. It comes to us from the folks over at Funko. Some of the characters listed on the front. We've got Slimer, Ray, the Stay Puff, and of course, there's, I was going to say Bill Murray, but there's Peter Bankman there on the other side. Up the top, it says free download code. I don't know what specifically you're downloading. I guess you could download, I guess, emojis. That makes some sense, doesn't it? Let's go ahead and open it. A little perforation on the side. I really don't need a knife for this. I'm going to peel that away. And who did we get? Did we actually get? We did get Peter Bankman himself. He's got these little boomerangs for eyes, a big giant smile. I can't help but notice there's a little smudging, a little bit of smudging on the side of his face. That's disappointing. It also looks like he's got a little bit of paint problems there right around the top of his hair. I really don't know what they're specifically to do. I guess they're literally doing it right now. You sort of are in on board the idea of Funkos, or sometimes, like myself, you just want to avoid them at all costs. For this, I don't really get these. I mean, it's just a head. Oh, and there's all this excessive glue or something on the back of it. But I don't generally get these. If you get these, congratulations. You get them and I don't. I just don't see the appeal of these myself. But apparently they do include some sort of code. I don't see where the code is supposed to be. Hello? Hello, code? I don't see a code. I guess there is no code inside. But, I mean, this is okay. I mean, if you like severed heads of Peter Venkman with boomerang eyes, then these fit that niche quite perfectly. To come also included inside, we got ourselves a t-shirt. And the t-shirt, oh, I like this one. We've got ourselves a Zool, Gatekeeper of Gozer. Very, very cool. I like that. It is obviously a black t-shirt. I'm listing, obviously, all the things that are very much something you can see for yourself. But you got a green terror dog on the front. And of course, it's official Ghostbusters merch. You can see right there. Probably going to wear that today. That's a nice-looking t-shirt. And I believe there was one last thing inside. We'll go ahead and pull that out right now. We've got ourselves the Overlook Hotel, a metal plaque from Fanatic. Crazy about collectibles. You can visit them over at www.fanatic.co.uk. But it looks to be a picture of the Overlook Hotel, all done in, well, it's a metal plaque. On the back it says The Shining. Doesn't say much of anything else. It says The Shining and all related characters and elements are Warner Brothers Entertainment, Inc. But it is a good, dense plaque. Yeah, I could do that. I could make use of that. I could certainly put that up in my movie room, which is probably where it's going to find a home. I like that. That's good. I almost didn't even see the fact it said The Shining down below. It was so dark and so hard to see. And yet, there it is right there. Very nice. Not bad. I was going to say that this may have been the price of admission, but admittingly, let's just quickly check in the box. Admittingly, there's a lot of good things that we got inside this box. We got the Golem Mini Co. Of course, we just last looked at the Overlook Hotel plaque. We got a severed head of Peter Venkman, which admittingly I might find to be the weakest thing inside this box. And we did get ourselves a Terror Dog t-shirt, which one last time we'll open up so you guys can see it. That might be my... Well, again, I think all of them stand up all well. I like horror films, and my favorite movie is The Shining, so that's a check mark. I like Lord of the Rings, and I like Golem. That's a check mark. I like The Ghostbusters. That's a check mark. The only thing that gets a passing mark by just barely is the severed stump, the severed head of Peter Venkman. I just don't get it. You get it? That's awesome. We can still be friends. I just don't get it. I just don't get the appeal of these. What I do certainly get the appeal of is every single month getting a Z-Box, which again, it seems like we may have not gotten one in a while. I'm so glad to finally see we're starting to get these Z-Boxes back. Z-Box is one of my favorite of the geek-related subscription boxes around. If you guys would like to subscribe to the Z-Box, you can click the link down below in the video description. Speaking of subscribing, make sure you're subscribing to this channel in 2021. Not only are we going to be looking at all subscription boxes that you're seeing right here, but there's going to be a ton of new things and new collectibles and figure reviews coming your way as well. So lots of stuff always brewing. Always brewing on this channel. I might as well just be a brewery. Needless to say, guys, as always, thanks for watching as you always do. Make sure you come back to this channel Monday to Friday, 12 p.m. and 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. 2 days, 2 times a day, 5 days a week. We have videos coming on a regular basis. Lots of stuff coming your way, guys. As always, again, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.